Hey everybody, it's Dom here from Lens Protego and Lens Rentals, and welcome back to the channel. So this weekend, I was asked to do a photo session for a hair salon who wanted to refresh the staff photos on their website. Now the owners wanted the photos to be done in the salon and in a 1 hour window of time before the salon opened. Now I don't do a ton of photo gigs, but I gather that this is probably a pretty common request. So I thought it would be a good idea for this week's video to show you how I did this pop-up portrait session and give you some tips on how I would shoot super quick on-location headshots. So I want to talk about this salon shoot first because it's a super good example of what you're able to do with a really minimal setup. So I started just by placing them next to this barn door and shooting opposite the window light. And I was already starting to get an image that I was liking, especially with that little bit of chairs and mirrors in the back, which really gives you that extra information about where they are. So the only problem was this location left me super smushed into the corner. And if I had brought any remote flashes to the shoot, I don't think I would have even been able to use them if I wanted to shoot in this little nook. So these pictures were taken with just one on-camera flash pointed directly up at the ceiling and one flex fill just to frame left to catch some of that light that was bouncing off the ceiling and give them a little bit more fill. And that's it, super simple and quick, and the client loved the pictures. So now I'm going to try to take the same lighting scenario that I had in the salon that day and try to recreate it somewhere here in the office to better show you how I did it. And I'm going to have some help from my friend Scarlett, who I just learned also just came from the hair salon. So once we do the super simple setup, then we're going to build up to something a little bit more involved, but I promise that you could take either of these setups to basically any location. Okay, so now I'm in a location similar to my salon shoot. We've got a window in the back, and I'm going to be bouncing my flash off the ceiling, which is a similar height to the salon's. If you're not able to bring a large soft light source to a photo shoot, a white ceiling is your best friend. If you power up your flash and aim it directly towards the ceiling, it's actually going to bounce off the ceiling and cast an excellent light on your subject. And this is true of white walls as well. Now, if we can just achieve a little bit of fall off on the face, then we're going to get a really nice looking portrait. So to help with this, I'm just gonna fly in a little flex fill to catch some of that light that's bouncing off the ceiling, and boom, we have a perfectly acceptable headshot that was done super quickly and with super minimal gear. So this salon shoot was a bit on the extreme side of shooting on a time crunch. So if you have more time and space on your shoot, then you'll like this next setup because it's pretty much foolproof for a great portrait and it's still really manageable and low footprint. So for this, we're just gonna pop this flash off the camera and onto a softbox and trigger it with this air remote. Flashing off the ceiling is nice, but when you do this, the light can get a little bit out of control. So if you're able to get your flash off of your camera and place it at a little bit more of an angle to your subject, this is going to look even better and give you a lot more control. Now once this is set up, I think you're going to find that this light alone is going to get you most of the way there. But to really perfect this, now I'm going to do the same idea with the reflector where I just angle a little bit so it catches some of the flash and fills in the opposite side of the face a little bit. Also, if you really wanted for more of like a traditional headshot that's just going to be shoulders up anyways, you can just ask your subject to sort of hug that flex bill sort of flat right in front of them, and that's going to do basically the same thing, and is going to eliminate a light stand if you're not going to be able to pull off having two light stands. Okay, so that's my super quick video on some of my tips for how I would shoot on-location headshots, especially when you're short on time and space. So I hope, if anything, you learned from this video that even with a super minimal photo setup, you can turn a lot of locations into an ideal area to shoot. So a few of my key takeaways here are survey the location before you start to shoot. Get an idea of the ceilings, the walls, the pre-existing light fixtures, and the windows, and be looking for anything that you can use to your advantage. If you can't bring the flash off camera, a white ceiling or a wall is your best friend. But if you can bring a remote flash, awesome. Just pop it in a softbox and then find the angle that works. And then I would recommend flying in a little reflector just to provide some fill. And just like that, now you have a few options to choose from for when you have a shoot like this one. So if you have any questions about the gear that I used in this video, or you have a question about my light setup, drop a comment in the comment section below, and we'll start a discussion about how you would shoot a pop-up portrait session. Also, if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button, and if you're not already, subscribe to the channel so you can stay tuned in for more of our weekly content. And we'll see you in the next one.